here we go. Okay, break! Cowboy 80! ready? Jeanette! Ready?
Can I talk my
come on
that other side
the Oakley way?
Hey,
C5,
can't nobody do me like I do me, and I don't care to be nobody else because I'm unique. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me. Dream so big might die in my sleep, and I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly them to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money. But don't get it twisted, still clocking big digits. I'm Rodeo big spending, all the cribs luxury. I can't recall the last time I did dishes, big business. All my deals 6 figures and up, when you get it out the mud, it hit different. Used to sell when the cops came, we hit fences. Now I'm blowing smoke out the country with two thick. I'ma take them both back to the penthouse and get. That's how it's supposed to be. Life is beautiful, I'm doing won't believe. Flew out to Colombia and brought me home some. Used to be the underdog, now they put me overseas. And I don't wanna be nobody else, nigga. Do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep. But I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly them to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money. I used to wanna be like Wayne. I used to wanna be like Nip with the Cuban link chain. I used to rap like Jay, trying to make me a name. Now all I do is C5. And I'ma stay in my lane. I could do anything I put my mind to, that's facts. I wanna be a but so I start. I like, so I went on and start flipping packs. I heard the drought 3 and said, dog, I'm a rap. I did that, superseded expectation. I refuse to settle for anything less than greatness. I'm the hottest rapper on the West, let's just face it. So put that pride to the side, then let's get paper. Can't nobody do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me, I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep, but I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly them to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money.
Bars, C5, just incredible. Hunger Flow 2, it's easy.
Incredible.
Sometimes they call me Lucifer. Talk about you do this and that. Ain't none of that done new to us. Nigga like that you pop off. No damn way that you grew to us. Been in my own lane. Carry you like that dude the truck. Trend following. I'm surprised you just now catching up. It's my way or the highway, baby girl. I'm not a settler. Don't play with my kind. No matter my mind. I promise it get pitiful. They love me. They love me. I promise I do the bare minimum. My people, they say that.
Run it back. Lost everything I ever wanted. Want it back. Got a problem, never run from that. Have fun with that. Get the W and then double back. That. Shit. Watch how I react. Fight back. Stay down. Now we taking off. Cut the flight. Promise you if anybody can. Homie, I can. The right man. Baby, I'm my own hype, man. Yeah. Run it back. Run it back. Run it back. Ooh, run it back. Run it back. Buy the snap, take a photograph. Run it back, make it to the friends. Run it back when I told the ride. I'll be back, make another van. Ultra fast. I ain't with the boat to dash. Run it back, I'm running back. Face back with the shoulder pads.
Run it back, watch your back. You think I want it cream, but I like it black. Bobby act, yeah. And run it back. You see how I act, but then I lack. Feel it like a fatal heart attack. I die for that. Stress about it. I think less without it. I'm a cut at anything that's in my psyche. Feeling myself high key. Running back, let me have it back. I'm a cut at anything that's in my psyche. Feeling myself high key.
Yes, like that. Solo might be right back. Oh, yes, like that.
This is the NFL on EA Sports, and we are thrilled to once again return to the gateway to the West, the proud city of St. Louis, Missouri. Today, after a topsy-turvy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here, as it'll be the Shamrocks of Oklahoma City taking on the Golden Eagles of St. Louis. 2-1 loss team set to lace it up. This ought to be fun, and we're underway on EA Sports. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. They'll start on the ground here on first down. And they'll get to him quickly here as he'll get just a yard to the 22.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A gain there of 21 yards. So, Charles, this game number two in the NFL career, this rookie quarterback, his guys took the loss in the opener. And when asked after that game by reporters how he did, he was pretty curt. He said, not well. What did you see?
Well, first and foremost, I loved his answer to the media because he was being...
And that's caught inside the 30. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. It's a gain of 35.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. Does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
He'll drop to throw. He'll connect on the out route with Ingram. All the way down inside the 5 to the 4. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Jump on top of the game's first score here this afternoon.
building confidence after a loss. That's a good way to do it. The loss last game, but first drive here on this one, cashing it in for six.
And they can talk all they want about putting a loss behind them. I think that drive there did more than any conversation they had, don't you think?
That's exactly right. Puts that to bed. And this is what they said all week long. A lot of things they needed to do differently. Whatever they said appears to have worked. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Now this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. Here on first down. This will be caught, Judy. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. First carry here for Kenneth Walker to third. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Walker now in first and 10. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Can't get away, and he's taken down. Brought down by Trayvon Walker on the pass rush.
I spent a lot of extra time preparing for this game, watching this offensive line, because they gave up 5 sacks last week in their loss. They just gave up another one now. They don't seem to be working together as a cohesive unit. Right? 4 guys might have it right, but the 5th guy is giving something up. They've got to find a way to all get on the same page.
Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want. Anytime they want to throw the football, there was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
And here's Dixon to punt now as he gets this one away. And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. This could end up being a pretty big drive. I mean, look, yes, it's early in this game, but they scored the touchdown. They got the stop. And now if they could get in the end zone here again, CD, they could grab an early stranglehold on this one.
Yeah, they certainly can, and that's what you're looking for. Where's the advantage? Can you gain it? Can you press it? Now for them, finishing it off, because right now it's out there for them. They've just got to go seize it.
After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. From the gun, Bigsby. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27.
That was a really nice run there to bring up 3rd and short. After the incompletion on 1st down, it's awfully nice to have a running back that you can hand it to and put you back in a good situation.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. On 3rd and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. The drive stays intact with a pickup of 13. Nothing, our score after one. St. Louis football here to begin quarter number two. As they've got it with a first and 10. Now back to throw. Completes it to Evan Ingram. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. And 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to fire one corner of the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Reek Woolen. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line.
He'd been having a good day so far, but I think he got a little overzealous on that one. Still young in this league. Has to learn to try not to do too much on an individual play because, as we all know, sometimes less is more. And throwing away is preferable to making the big mistake.
Boy, nowhere to go at all on that first down run as they will get to him behind the line of scrimmage.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. On play action, they'll throw. On the move to his, and he can't find the receiver, and he's brought down. Now Charles dealing with a third and long. They'll have to try to go back to the air again, and this time avoid the sack.
Certainly hard to try to establish momentum when all you're doing is going backwards, not protecting the passer, and he gets dumped on his backside.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. It's Kyler Duggar who picks it, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line. So first and 10 now from the 30. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
They certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. A play action fake. They'll look to throw. Over the middle, complete. It's Watkins. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. First catch for him on the afternoon, and it results in a first down. Here's a give to Bigsby. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Second and 6 with the ball on the 7. He'll look to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Rice. Touchdown! Rasheed Rice with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Golden Eagles are able to widen their advantage. So after the disappointment in the opening week loss, Charles, this looks like really a completely different football team.
They sure do, and I think they realize we can't start 0-2. And they're determined to not let it happen by the looks of things here in the early going.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. Doug Peterson says, let's go for 2 here. They'll try and throw for it. And he's got it here for the 2 points, but there is a marker down, so we'll have to see what that's about.
So a roughing the passer penalty there, CD.
And we know that these pass rushers love to get after rookie quarterbacks, but they've still got to do it within the scope of the rules. And that time, the hit came just a little bit too late. And the official won't even think twice about pulling his flag on that one.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now a play fake here on first down. Completes the pass to Judy on the crossing pattern. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. That one goes for 24 yards.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half, but I like their countenance. I like the way that they're having panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball, and what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
A run on first down, but it's not going to get them much. Maybe a yard, and that's all.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
Sticking with Walker on second down.
They find some open field here. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They're going to look to throw. Looking for Lockett, and he's got him, working his way free across the middle. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. Now a first and 10 at the 11. They'll toss this out right to Walker. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Kenneth Walker, his second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Shamrocks have cut it back within a score.
Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. There was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
From the 21, it's second and 10. They'll set up to throw. They'll complete this to Ingram as tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Well, at first and 10, it's Bigsby.
And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Now another timeout called for by the offense, as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one.
This is second and 8.
He'll look to throw. A short throw to Ingram. A solid stiff arm. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. They were looking to throw, holding in a big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. You're going to pick up a holding call.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Looking to throw. His throw incomplete.
I think the defenders have to feel pretty good. Even though the ball was tipped in the air and could have become a big play for the offense, they actually won one because the guy flinging it today, he's having quite the performance. A couple of touchdown passes, almost threw his first interception, but he's throwing it so well, I think Lady Luck was on his side.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Watkins. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. It'll be a gain of 12, but it will also lead to fourth down. Here's Tommy Townsend on to punt. Back deep, the dangerous Tyler Lockett. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get in the field goal range. Under pressure, and down he goes. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0-for-3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
And he'll take it just outside the 40. Just a net of 34 there, following a pile of 44 yards. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That'll be caught by Rice. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out.
So many times in my career, I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
And his kick here is good. And that will do it for this first half. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. A 10-point game, 17-7 the score as we get back to it on EA Sports. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stout troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. That's going to be caught by Judy. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That'll put him at 77 yards receiving for the ball game. It's a first down. A gear for Walker running right. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
But these guys got to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage would be found.
And this shot downfield on second down is brought in. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. It's Connor Duggar who puts it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line. Reek Woolen in on the stop.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up five, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
From the 21, here's a second and 5. Back to throw here. Steps away. And that is going to be incomplete as he led him a bit too much.
Well, you know me, whether you need it or not, I'm going to give a little unsolicited advice. Just throw it downfield out of the pocket only if you're absolutely sure. Otherwise, use your running ability and try and get those yards a safer way.
They'll drop to throw. And he's caught, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. They give him 7 yards on the play, and they do pick up the conversion on third down. But things looking much rosier for him here in week two. They work with the lead as they've got it first and 10. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. Picked off by Devin Witherspoon. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. They brought the house that time on the young rookie, maybe a little rattled through the pick.
And you have to be prepared for a lot of pressure as a rookie quarterback because most defensive coordinators are going to test you that way. So when you see that, the ball's got to get out of your hands quickly, and that means your receivers have to understand they have to break off their routes quickly as well.
To the right side, this is Walker. And he's got some space here. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 72 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
Now that's a big-time run. Lightning in a bottle, forget it. He exploded out of the bottle for that type of a pickup.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. They'll run the toss to Walker. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. They'll look to throw here. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. George Karloftis. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. And they'll run the end around here with Judy. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. So on now comes the kicker. It's Jason Myers. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. Myers' kick is good, and they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10. The tackle made by Boye Mafe.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
Here's second and 7 now from the 28. They'll look to throw. Looking left side for Watkins, and he's got it. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
Time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record.
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Trayvon Walker picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Well, collectively as a defense, Charles, I think if you get four sacks a game, you're feeling really good. Now they have six as a unit.
And that type of a number is just staggering because there's so many ways to try and counteract it. But in this case, they've got no answers for this unrelenting pressure coming at their quarterback.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. They'll set up a throw. This will be caught, Judy. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 23 yards the pickup there. Now this offense hoping to avoid the 0-2 start. They trail, but they've got a first and 10 here. Trying the left side with Walker. And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15. 83 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. They run again with Walker. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
On second down, it's Walker. He will push his way down to about the 14. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. But this feels like a late season game, even though it's just week two. Here's a big third down. And it's caught. Touchdown. Tyler Lockett, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Shamrocks are an extra point away from tying this game here in the final minutes.
And we are set up for a fantastic finish now. A fourth quarter touchdown here. We're an extra point away from a tie football game.
And I know they're thinking about possibly going for two, but I'd go ahead and kick this one and just get it back to level.
Don't forget the extra point. It's up and good. And we are tied here in the fourth quarter.
Now this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Here's first and 10.
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
They certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
They'll come up now on second down.
Back to throw. A short throw to Ingram. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30.
I like what I'm seeing from them here. A tie game in the fourth quarter. They understand the situation. They don't need to be in any rush. Go ahead and huddle up and run your offense. That last completion put them in a nice position to take the lead in this game.
All three timeouts plus the two-minute warning. Here's first and 10.
Now back to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. So it's our home team here in possession of the football as we come back. They've got a second down now as they search for a score to break this tie.
Another try, second and 10 now.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
Finding Watkins. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
That's a nice job right there, Carmen, because they were able to work down the middle of the field, working in the seams, because I think defensively, they were guarding the sidelines, trying to keep them from getting out of bounds. They took what they gave them, and it was successful.
Rolling to his left.
God, that is incomplete.
I guess you can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
Well, to your point, it was a nice job of knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guys going downfield to catch the ball, they've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
Here comes second down.
To throw again. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. Third and long coming up defensively. You pressure the quarterback or drape ball over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback and then make sure you blanket the field.
He's got his target. That's complete. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20.
Now that is the two-minute drill at its very best. Get the completion, get a big chunk of yardage, and then get out of bounds to save those timeouts. You cannot do it any better than that.
On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
Partner, you've got about 20 coaches on your payroll, but there's 60,000 of them in the stands. I don't think any of them like that play.
And the later we go, it's starting to sound like 100,000 in here.
They'll try again here. Second and 10.
He'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And that's a touchdown as they break another tie here in the final minute of the third. We saw so much of this last year at the college level, but there you go. His first rushing touchdown as an NFL quarterback.
And with the speed he has, we certainly know it won't be his last, because that's something that aided him very well, as you mentioned, at the college level. It's something he's going to carry over, and they'll make it a big part of their offense.
No going for two. They'll kick the punt after. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. They'll come up first and 10 here. He's back to throw. Able to find Judy, and he's brought down, but great yardage to start the drive, a first down, and it sets him up pretty nicely here moving forward.
So that run is still likely to lead to a new set of downs.
Yeah, they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. This offense cannot stop the clock now. No timeouts remaining as they come up here first down. Looking for Lockett, and he's got him, working his way free across the middle. Wonder what a finish to this one.
On my attire, these righteous keep on growing, but my jeans getting tighter. I went over. I talk my...
Come on!
That other side...
The Oakland way!
Hey!
C5!
Can't nobody do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep. And I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly him to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money. But don't get it twisted, still clocking big digits. On Rodeo, big spending. All the cribs, luxury. I can't recall the last time I did dishes. Big business. All my deals, six figures and up. When you get it out the mud, it hit different. You should sell when the cops came, we hit fences. Now I'm blowing smoke out the country with two thick. I'ma take them both back to the penthouse and get. That's how it's supposed to be. Life is beautiful, I'm doing small believe. Flew out to Colombia and brought me home some. Used to be the underdog, now they put me overseas. And I don't wanna be nobody else, nigga. Do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep. But I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it.
Fact.
I turned to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly him to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money. I used to wanna be like Wayne. I used to wanna be like Nip with the Cuban link chain. I used to rap like Jay, trying to make me a name. Now all I do is C5. And I'ma stay in my lane. I could do anything I put my mind to, that's facts. I wanna be a dealer, so I start. I like, so I went on and start flipping packs. I heard the drought three and said, dog, I'm a rap. I did that, superseded expectation. I refuse to settle for anything less than greatness. I'm the hottest rapper on the West, let's just face it. So put that pride to the side, then let's get paper. Can't nobody do me like I do me. And I don't care to be nobody else, cause I'm unique. I'm fine with me, I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep, but I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turn to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly him to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money.
Bars, C5, just incredible. Hunger flow too. It's easy.
Incredible.
Top ramen now, steak and lobster with a shrimp, eh? Yeah. Bitch, put a ribbon on it, get you.